What's up, guys? Today, in today's video, I'll be showing you how to add a GUI to your menu. So if you're making your menu and you know what you're doing, so yeah, let's get right into it. So first of all, you obviously want your menu open. You want to right click on one of the yellow boxes, add, and then class. On class, you want to get rid of class 1 or whatever it is and change it to GUI or whatever you want your GUI thing to be. You want to click add, and then on here you want to remove that. You want to come to my Discord, what's in the description. If you do need help, ask in there. I won't be helping in the comments, so be sure to join my Discord. You want to download this. It's under Joe's menu on GUI temp. You want to download it, and then after you downloaded it, this should come up. You want to control A, control C, so it's copy and pasting it. And then after you've done that, you can close it down. You want to reopen it and then just paste it. And yeah, so you've added your GUI. There are 5 buttons in here, well, already been added, what you can use. Otherwise, the mods are already Speed Boost, Com Boost, Inverse Monkey, and Ghost Monkey. You want to scroll to the top. Change this to your menu name, so mine's going to be encryptic.gui. Make sure it's all lowercase, and then over here where it says Joe's GUI temp, change it with your menu name encrypted GUI. And then you want to scroll down here. If you do need help with any of it, like I said, it will be my Discord. You can remove SpazMonkey unless you already got a SpazMonkey code. And then on here, you got here. So if we add in, like, let's say long arms, you only remove new mod 1, type long arms, copy again here. And then after we've done that, you want to scroll down. Keep scrolling. Till you get here. And like I said, these are going to be for your button names. So on mod 1, you want to change it. So that says long arms. And as we're going to be adding a long arms mod, let's just do it quickly. So make sure it is private voids, or otherwise public ones will just break it sometimes. So private void long arms. So let's add a simple long arms code now. So gorilla locomotion dot player dot instance dot transform. Oh no, I read that right. Wrong one. Gorilla player instance transform dot local scale equals new vector 3. I would always type though here unity engine dot vector 3, just so you don't get any errors. You want to put a semicolon here, and because we're doing long arms, we'll just put them 1.5. This is 1.5 comma 1.5 comma 1.5, like that. And make sure in between, well, straight after the fives, make sure you put F's, so it's like that. And then after that, you just want to copy this, and then you can type off long arms or whatever you're using. And yeah, with that, you want to type public static void arms. Like that. Public static void arms. Then you just want to put that. Public. Actually, you could just put these to public static if you would like to try as well. So, if it does break, just keep it private. Public static void. I think it's because it's the capital. Yeah. Make sure it's always lowercase. Public long arms, you can enter. Do another one of them, backspace else. Enter. Off long arms. You may get some errors here, but it's a pretty simple fix. I'll let you guys work that out. Then after you've done that, so it said arms, you want to come up to where it says mod 1 and put long arms or whatever you have yours as, depending on what you have it. I'm not saying you are going to use long arms, but and just for the video, we'll just do off here. Off long arms. And here, I'll just put off. Long arms, and then when you scroll up, here, you just put, let me just make sure the names are always the same, and so I'll just grab off long arms from here. And then add it here as that's one of the actions. And yeah, let's load up to the game. After this, I will show you how to change your name of the GUI. So let me just show you that it does work before the build. You just wanna obviously build your thing, go into your template or whatever you're using, get the DLL, and you just want to put that in, go on Gorilla Tag depending if you're using it on Steam or what you call it, Oculus Standalone. Ooh. Give me a second. Just for this, I'm going to go on one of my currently banned accounts. What, I nearly unbanned, so yeah. Give it a second. It's just loading up. This GUI is very easy to use once you get the hang of it. And like I said, if you do get stuck, ask in the Discord and I will help you guys. And yeah. Being as I know there isn't really a lot of GUIs currently out, I thought I'd make one, and people saying they would like one, so I thought, why not help them? Give me a sec, just opening. The GUI will be top left. You can't move it, but maybe in future ones that you'll be able to move it. So as you can see up here, it says GUI name with the color. You can just move it left or right like this. It changes the color of it depending on, yeah, with the name, you just put anything random and it will change, but being as I'm banned, my name doesn't change. Join room code, then on mods, you click onto mods, this will open. If I do, give me a sec. If I do Invis Monkey, as you can see, I'm invisible. And Ghost Monkey, as you can see, Ghost Monkey. It does go red box when it's activated. Long arms, as you can see now, I've got long arms. Off long arms. I'm not working as I'm not really on VR, so. But you guys can work them out. It's pretty simple. As you see, it says mods GUI at the top. So if we go back to the code, control F and search up mods GUI. You want to come down to draw mods GUI, and where it says mods GUI here, you change it with your own GUI name, and yeah, that's basically the GUI thing. You can always change the colors here and whatnot. You can mess around the colors, but if it breaks, I'm not helping you, unfortunately, because that's your own problem. But anything else, I'll help with. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, like and subscribe, and yeah.